I'm also a body neutral personal trainer and an anti-diet culture coach. I believe.
Good evening, Fetterflies. I know I'm supposed to be taking a day off, but I just had to, right? So my kid comes to me and says, you know, I've been watching this guy who is on YouTube Shorts, and he seems like he's like anti-diet, but it's really confusing because I think he's also pro weight loss. And I said, okay, well, send me the link. I'll watch it and we'll see. Oh, and I did. Now, my kid's question was, isn't this at least better than all of the people who are pushing like really hardcore starvation diets, etc.? My answer is, you know, I don't think so. I think it's just as bad. So you have this thin white man who has appropriated talk from the fat liberation movement, things like intuitive eating, things like body neutrality, like anti-diet coach. By the way, I seriously never trust a thin person who claims to be anti-diet and is making money off of it. He's appropriating these things not only for profit, but also to just sell weight loss. But it's a different kind of weight loss. It's a healthy kind of weight loss. It's a sustainable kind of weight loss. It's a lifestyle change. Yeah, we've heard that before. And why is it worse? Why is it more dangerous? Why is it just as bad at the very least? Because it's insidious. Because there's really obvious diet culture mentality that you can go, ooh, yeah, no, that is really toxic. Don't do that. And then there's the insidious kind that makes you question whether or not it's really diet culture, and maybe it makes sense, but they still seem to be pushing weight loss, but maybe it's not that bad. And it digs into you and it replaces the diet mentality brain worm. And he says, you have to do these things in moderation. But let me tell you why that doesn't work and why that still just causes eating disorders. He thinks he's found the key because he uses the word moderation like we've never heard that before. But weight loss doesn't work no matter what you use, no matter what lifestyle change it is. And it's not sustainable, and here's why. Because you do the thing, you do the things he says, and the weight loss doesn't stick. You gain it back. So you try something a little bit more extreme, and that doesn't stick either. So you keep going more and more extreme, trying to keep weight loss off, and it just doesn't work. Ooh, part two coming up. Part two on Adam Wright Fitness. Now, if you watch his videos, he talks a lot about feminism and the messaging that diet culture sends little girls and things like that. And so we have a man who is pushing weight loss, which is rooted in racism and misogyny, right? We already know that. Mansplaining the effects of diet culture on women and young girls, while also teaching diet culture and saying that it's anti-diet culture. And y'all know I stopped making videos and talking directly to fat phobes. What I worry about is people within the fat liberation community, people within the fat acceptance community, seeing things like this, seeing words like anti-diet coach, words like body neutrality, and confusing it with somebody who's actually anti-fat phobia, etc. And I'm afraid that it's going to get people who are already at risk of falling back into the trap of disordered eating because this man is using our own language against us. Again, intentional weight loss is never sustainable. And intentional weight loss, by the way, includes going into something wanting to lose weight, but telling yourself that, oh, I'm just doing this for my health, and if I happen to lose weight, you know. That's still intentional. It's just intentional and you're lying to yourself. You know how they say if you have an eating disorder, you are never recovered, you're always recovering? I think the same thing is true for disordered eating. And the idea that quote unquote improving your health is just going to cause natural weight loss is such bullshit. But that also operates under the assumption that fat people are fat because they're doing unhealthy things. And if they would just do the healthy things, then they would at least lose some of the weight. But first, let's note that a fat person who loses 20 pounds is still a fat person, and you're not really escaping any of the oppression. That part really, really does suck. None of us are out here having fun being oppressed. And that's the problem with covert fat phobia. You don't even notice it until after the damage is done. And that doesn't mean you can't care about your health or care about joyful movement. It just means that none of those things have anything to do with your body size or weight. And anyone who's trying to convince you that it does is still just peddling diet culture. So I'm talking directly to my fat siblings. Please do not fall for this. It is just fat phobia and diet culture repackaged using our own language. They have always used our own language to repackage our oppression.